got to see his work. No one is doing what Pollock is doing. Yes, of course. It would be just great if you could stop by. Wonderful. We'll look forward to it. Bye.
Lee!
Reuben! Hello.
Lee Krasner, Howard Putzel.
How nice to meet you.
Oh, no.
Howard's been working with Peggy Guggenheim.
Howard. Of course.
Reuben's here with Howard Putzel. He works with Peggy Guggenheim.
Reuben!
When'd you get back?
What the hell? I thought you were in Los Angeles.
They got me stationed in Brooklyn.
Look at you.
Jackson. This is Howard Putzel.
I am so very pleased to meet you.
I've known this guy since high school.
I met Howard in Los Angeles before he hooked up with Peggy in Paris.
Please, Peggy.
We just ran into each other yesterday.
Barbara and the kids.
Oh, they're good. They're coming out in a couple of weeks.
How long are you here for?
I don't know. They say they're going to ship me out to India, but who knows? What about you?
4F. Too neurotic.
It's all.
Yeah, move so we can see this.
Genius. Peggy must see this.
May, hi. How are you?
Hi, May.
Come on, Jackson.
I'm so glad you made it. Lee Krasner, Jackson Pollock, James Johnson Sweeney from The Modern.
Nice to meet you.
Miss Peggy Guggenheim.
Hello.
Mr. Pollock, Howard has been talking about you. Thank you, Howard. You must see Jackson's work.
Yes, well, enjoy yourself.
I like those earrings.
Thank you.
Groups create powerful art. But I'm not necessarily talking about groups of artists. Patrons, aficionados, collectors, academics, fans, journalists, philanthropists, and museum directors all create art that comes to be seen as socially significant, worthy of taking up gallery or museum space, worthy of hanging on your wall, and perhaps worthy of reading about someday in your art history class. This statement is not a knock against artists. Bourdieu and other sociologists who write about the art world have little to say about artwork itself, about whether a particular painting is good or bad or ugly or pretty. Stating that groups create powerful art acknowledges that the production of art, and culture more generally, is a social process. Bourdieu would remain neutral on the question of whether Pollock was a talented artist. But he would most certainly say that Jackson Pollock had a high degree of social capital. If this clip is historically accurate, Pollock was content to remain hungover in bed. But he was married to artist Lee Krasner, who made the necessary connections for him to break into the art world. Pollock's high school buddy was sculptor and muralist Reuben Kadish. Krasner met Kadish. Kadish knew gallery owner Howard Putzel. And Putzel worked with one of the most important patrons of 20th century art, Peggy Guggenheim. Groups create powerful art, but they need to be composed of the right people. And Pollock supporters definitely had the social, economic, and cultural capital needed to catapult his career. At the same time, Pollock's social capital enabled others to discover and embrace him as one of the most important artists of the 20th century.